गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 6, नॉर्थ एंड साउथ अमेरिका, पॉलिटिकल एंड फिजिकल डिवीजन, क्लास 6 एंड टॉपिक ऑफ ज्योग्राफी. सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द पॉलिटिकल एंड फिजिकल डिवीजन ऑफ नॉर्थ एंड साउथ अमेरिका. सो एज वी नो दैट साउथ एंड नॉर्थ अमेरिका थर्ड एंड फोर्थ लार्जेस्ट कॉन्टिनेंट. सो फर्स्टली आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द नॉर्थ अमेरिका. So, North America is the third largest continent that lies in the northern and western hemisphere. And it was named after the explorer Amerigo Vespucci, but the real credit is given to Christopher Columbus for the discovery of North America. So, that together continent of North America and South America were referred as to the New World. So, firstly, I will discuss about the physical division of North America. So, physical division of North America, the physical features, North America is divided into four parts. First one, Canadian Shield. Second one is Western Mountain System or Western Cordillera. Third one is Eastern Highlands. And fourth one is Great Central Plains. So, firstly, the Canadian Shield. It is also popularly known as the Laurentian Shield. And it extends from the Hudson Bay to Great Lakes in its North America. The five Great Lakes includes Lake Huron, Lake Ontario, Lake Michigan, Lake Erie, and Lake Superior. So these five Great Lakes make the center Canadian Shield and Laurentian Shields rich with the water sources and also provide a fertile land that is suitable for agriculture and suitable for the flora and fauna. The second physical division of North America is a Western Mountain System or Western Cordillera. What is a Cordillera? Cordillera is a range of mountain system. Parallel range of mountain system is called a Cordillera. So, Western Cordillera, a chain of parallel mountains is known as the Cordillera and it spread from Alaska to the Isthmus of Panama. So, number of active volcanoes and extinct volcanoes and earthquakes are also found in the Western Mountain System and Western Cordillera. Deep valleys with vertical sides are mostly formed here, and these valleys are known as canyon and gorges. Canyon and gorges, those are narrow deep valleys, are also located in the Western Mountain System and Western Cordillera. The third one, physical division of North America, also known as the Eastern Highlands. It is also popularly known as the Appalachian Mountain System. Its height ranges from 1200 to 1500 meter, and these are parallel from Newfoundland to North Atlanta. And Mountain Washington is highest point in the Eastern Highlands and Appalachian Mountain System, and many rivers and glaciers and lakes are also formed in the Eastern Highlands. The last one division of the North America is the Central Lowland, Central Great Plains, and also known as a Lowland North America. These are located between the Western Cordillera, Western Cordillera, Canadian Shields, and Eastern Highlands. So the Great Central Plains, that is also known as the Central Lowlands, it is located between Canadian Shield, Western Mountain Cordillera, and Eastern Highlands. And these are mostly formed and drained by the major rivers of North America. The first one river is a river Mississippi, and second river is a river McKenzie. So these rivers provide abundant water sources and a supply of water to the Central Lowlands and the Great Central Plains. The next one is a political division of the North America. As we know that North America is the third largest continent, and the largest country in the North America, countries in the North America are Canada and United States. And the remainder is made up of Mexico and Central America. The next one is a case study in the Canada. Case study in Canada, lumbering. In the case study, we will study about the lumbering activity in the Canada. So what is the lumbering? Lumbering is a process of cutting the trees and carrying it to the sawmills and factories for getting the wood that is used for the production of paper, newsprint, synthetic plants, and it also includes the planting, growing and cutting and caring for the plants. So cutting the woods and transporting it to the pulp factories and sawmills is called a logging, and the carrying the process of wood that is done by the person that is called a lumberjack. So lumberjacks are person who cut the trees into equal length and carrying it to the sawmills and factories are called lumberjacks and lodgers. So next one is a different task under the lumbering activities. So there are four tasks under the lumbering activities. Different task under the lumbering. So first one is a high riggers. Second one, buckers. Third one is a skidder. And the last fourth one is a haulers. These are four different tasks under the lumbering activity. First one is a high riggers. The main function of the high riggers is to climb the tall trees, tall coniferian trees, and cut their branches. And after cutting the branches, they cut the top of trees. Then second one is a buckers. The main work of the buckers is to cut the branches into an equal length, and the length of branches varies into 4.5 to 5 meters. The third one is a skidder. Skidders are those persons who pull and drag the log and branches to the road, rails and river sides. The fourth one is a haulers. And haulers are a person who help to move the logs, drawn and the streams. So four different tasks are performed under the lumbering activities. The next one is a uses. What are uses of the lumbering activities? So lumbering provide a wood for the manufacturers, for the production of newsprints, plants and for the furnitures, and it also provided timber for building and furniture material, building materials, plywood production, etc. So in the North America, we have studied about the political division, about the physical division of the North America, and the case study lumbering in Canada. The next topic is South America. So South America is the fourth largest continent in the world, and it is connected to the North America by the Isthmus of Panama, and it lies in the southern hemisphere. The largest country in the South America is Brazil, and the smallest country is Suriname, and the largest river is Amazon, and largest freshwater lake is Lake Titicaca. And the location of the South America in the world map, the Tropic of Cancer passes through the South America, and River Amazon has an equator passing near its mouth, and 6 degrees west longitude divides the South America into the equal parts. So next one is the physical division of the South America. So on the basis of physical features, the South America is divided into four categories. So first one is the Indus Mountain System. So Indus Mountain System, Indus are major mountain of the South America, and its height ranges more than 8000 km and its width varies between 300 km. The high plateau of the Quito lies here also, and Lake Titicaca also located in the Indus Mountain System, and it has three parallel ranges, western, central and eastern cordilleras, and it experienced active volcanoes and earthquakes. These are physical features of the Andes Mountain System. The next one, physical division of the South America, is the central coastal, the coastal plains. The coastal plains, it lies between the Indus and Pacific Ocean, and it is the longest central plains in the world, and its width is about 80 km. The fourth one, physical division of the South America, is the central lowlands, the central area that lies in the low, at the feet of the South America. So these are formed by the large river basin. The largest river, Amazon, starts from the mouth of central lowlands. So largest river, Amazon, it starts from the mouth of central lowlands. And this basin is formed by three major rivers. First one, river Zurugay. Then second one, river Parana. Then third one, river is a Paraguay. The water of these rivers flow into a body of waters known as a Rio de la Plata or the river of silver. So fourth one, physical division of South America, the Eastern Highlands. It extends from Brazilian Highlands to the Guiana Highlands and separated by Amazon River. Angel Falls, the world's highest waterfalls, also located in the Eastern Highlands, and the height of these fall is a 979 meter, and the Patagonia Plateau lies in the Eastern Highlands. So these four physical divisions of the South America. The next one is a case study in the South America, life in the Amazon Basin. The Amazon, as we know that Amazon is the largest river in the South America. So we will study about the life of people, about the life of flora and fauna in the Amazon Basin. So Amazon River Basin is the largest river basin in the world, and Amazon River is the second longest river after the river Nile, that is situated in the South America, and it is spread across the countries like Bolivia, Brazil, Colombia, Ecuador, French Guiana, and Guyana, Peru, Suriname, and Venezuela. So these countries through which it across river Amazon spread. The Amazon River Basin spread from Brazilian Highlands in the south to the Guiana Highlands in its north. The next one is the climate in the Amazon River Basin. So as we know that Amazon River Basin is situated near the equator, so it experiences two kind of climate, a wet climate or a less wet season. So wet season runs from September to May, and the less wet season is from June to August, and difference between the day and night temperature varies between 2 to 5 degrees Celsius. The next one is a plant life, flora life near the Amazon River Basin. So plant life, Amazon River Basin is a home to almost 40,000 plant species, and about these plants have a medical values. These plants are used for producing the medicines, and it also provide a huge resources to mankind like timber, like compound valued in agriculture, medicine such as cure, and it provide the bark of the forest that is situated in the Amazon River Basin. It provide a cinchona trees provide a quinine that is used as a medicine or remedy for treating the malaria. The next one is the animal life, fauna life in the Amazon Basin. So Amazon River Basin is a home to more species of plant as well as animal also. So it includes 4,000 plant species, 427 mammals. It includes 1,300 birds, 378 reptiles, and 400 freshwater fishes. And the next one, population in the Amazon River Basin. So Amazon Basin is a very sparsely populated because it situated near the equator. So here population is very less. The majority of the people live in Amazon in the cities and towns. And people in Amazon River Basin clear out some of the forest, and they use a slash and burn agriculture process. The main crops cultivated by the people of the Amazon Basin River include tapioca, pineapple, and sweet potatoes. They also eat queen ants and egg sacs. And the people of Amazon Basin River also cultivated cash crops like coca, maize, and coffee. So in this chapter, we have studied about the physical and political division of North and South America. And in the North America, we have studied case study, lumbering activity in the Canada and Amazon River Basin. So in the come the page number 112 and 113. Here true, false, fill in the blanks, matching, and tick the correct option, and one word are given. So you have to read the chapter thoroughly and try to find out the word meaning, word meaning and their meanings, word and their meanings, and also define the technical terms that is given below the each page, and write down in your notebooks. Thanks and have a nice day.